Hey, it's Dr. Hannah with this week's Hot Topic. Today I want to talk to you about springtime allergies. Spring is super beautiful, but it's also a key time of the year for seasonal allergies. As plants release pollen, millions of people with hay fever start to sniffle and sneeze. Now, the biggest spring allergy trigger is typically pollen. So trees, grasses, weeds, they release these tiny grains into the air to fertilize other plants. However, when they get into the nose of somebody who's allergic, they send their body's defense system crazy. So the immune system, when that happens, mistakenly sees the pollen as a danger, releases the antibodies that attacks the allergens, which then leads to the release of chemicals called histamine into the blood. Histamines trigger that runny nose, the itchy eyes, and other symptoms that you are all too familiar with if you have seasonal allergies. Now, pollen counts tend to be particularly high on breezy days when the wind picks up those sneeze-inducing grains and carries them lots of different places. Rainy days are typically the days where it washes all the other pollens, and you usually tend to feel the best and you can breathe the best. So you like the sun, but yet at the same time, rainy days as you start to feel better. Now, if you're not sure if you do have allergies, so symptoms you may have are like runny nose and not related to a cold. You have watery eyes, you're sneezing, you're coughing. The big one that I've probably noticed is like your itchy eyes and itchy nose. And typically you have dark circles under your eyes, specifically like right here, almost kind of looks like a raccoon a little bit. There are certain medications and supplements that can help ease some of those symptoms of the allergies. Typically, the most common ones are like an antihistamine because it's going to reduce your sneezing, sniffling, itching, and because they lower the amount of histamine in your body. You can also use some decongestants because it shrinks the blood vessels in the nasal passageways. So that helps relieve some of that congestion and swelling. And there are actually things that combine them together. So it's an antihistamine and a decongestant combo, which again will combine the effects of both of the drugs. Now, I like more of the natural effects and the more of the natural remedies. So here are some natural remedies that you can do at home that are quite effective. So one that is become a little bit more popular is the nasal irrigation, which is like the warm water. You use some tablespoon of salt and baking soda to clear out the mucus, and it opens your sinus passages. You can do this with a neti pot or like a squeeze bottle. It looks super weird, so like don't watch somebody do it first, but basically you pour it in your nose and it comes out the other side. Typically you use like sterile or distilled water. You can boil the water if you want to, let it cool down before you do it. But that can like really clear out your passages really well. So neti pot or like I said, an irrigation squeeze bottle, they're super common. You can get them at any grocery store, any pharmacy or anything has them. Another supplement that works really well is called quercetin. So this nutrient is normally found in like onions, apples, black tea, and it's actually been shown in research that it can block the release of histamines. So that's something else that you can take, and it's usually like a yellow pill. So I have 5 tips for you today that if you do suffer from allergies that hopefully can help you make it through this season. So one, unfortunately, you do want to stay indoors whenever the pollen count is super high. So usually avoid peak hours, and just if you have to go out, don't go out in the mornings. Keep your doors and windows clean during the spring months to keep the allergens out. Air purifiers can also help, but unfortunately you don't want to open your windows up too much because it'll bring those pollens inside. Clean the air filters out in your homes. That's something else most people don't think of. Also, you want to make sure you clean bookshelves, vents, other places where pollen can collect. So make sure it's all nice and clean. Number 4 is wash your hair after you've gone outside, because it can actually stick to your hair and you don't realize that you're like, oh man, and your hair's dangling down and it can just get inside your face and your nasal passages, and that can kind of be a thing that just is kind of a recurrence. So if you are outside for a long period of time, just make sure you take a shower, wash your hair really good. And then the last thing that you can do, especially if you have allergies, is you want to vacuum at least twice a week. Again, your carpet can really hold on to a lot of those allergens or the pollens, and that can just constantly make you have some allergy symptoms. So hopefully that's super helpful. Hopefully you're not suffering too bad from all those allergies. And if you are, you're going to make it through. Summer's almost here. And yeah. All right. That's all I have for you guys this week. We'll see you guys next time.